ओके, वेलकम टू द साइबर सिक्योरिटी लैब। ओके, टुडे आई विल गिव सम डिटेल्स अबाउट रूट किट। ओके, एंड यू कैन यूज दिस डिटेल्स टू मेक योर असाइनमेंट रिलेटेड टू रूट किट्स एज थियरी। ओके, you have to write the some details about rootkits and their types and the activity done using rootkit. Okay, so rootkit is a stealthy type of software and typically malicious, designed to hide the existence of certain processes or programs from normal methods of detection and enables continued privileged access to a computer. So basically it's a software program. Okay, rootkit. So again, what is a rootkit? So rootkit is a clandestine computer program designed to provide continued privilege access to a computer. Okay, there is no login or access permission. Okay, continued privilege access to a computer while actively hiding its presence. Okay, the term rootkit is a connection of the two words root and kit. And originally a rootkit was a collection of tools that enabled administrator level access to a computer or network. Okay, so these there are several tools used in rootkit to control the computer and network. Root refers to the admin account on Unix and Linux systems, and kit refers to the software component that implement the tool. Okay, so several rootkit softwares are available on the net to access this special privilege access. Okay, and today rootkits are generally associated with malware such as trojans, worms, viruses, and that conceals their existence and actions from users and other system processes. Okay, what can a rootkit do? So a rootkit allows someone to maintain command and control over a computer without the computer user or owner knowing about it. Okay, so it is completely hidden. Once a rootkit has been installed, the controller of the rootkit has the ability to remotely execute files and change system configuration on the host machine. Okay, 1 minute. Okay, now a rootkit on an infected computer can also access log files and spy on the legitimate computer owners' uses. So all details will be accessed by this rootkit tools. Okay, and there is has the ability to execute files and change the system configuration also. So here is the rootkit detection. So it is difficult to detect rootkits. Okay, normally, and there are no commercial product available that can find and remove all known and unknown rootkits. And there are various ways to look for a rootkit on an infected machine. Detection methods include behavioral based methods, looking for strange behavior on a computer system, like signature scanning, another technique. Okay, and memory dump analysis. And often the only option to remove a rootkit is to completely rebuild the compromised system. So you have to rebuild your system, or you reconfigure your system to remove rootkit. Okay, completely rebuild. Then rootkit protection. So many rootkits penetrate computer system by piggybacking with software you trust or with virus, and you can safeguard your system from rootkits by ensuring it is kept patched against known vulnerabilities. And this includes patches of your OS applications and up-to-date virus definitions also. And don't accept files or open emails, file attachments from unknown sources. There may be possibility of rootkit program, okay, malicious program. And be careful when installing software, and carefully read the end user license agreements. Okay, one of the term is static analysis. So static analysis can detect backdoors and other malicious insertions such as rootkits. Okay, enterprise developers as well as IT departments buying ready-made software can scan their application to detect threats including spatial and hidden credentials backdoors. So static analysis will help you to detect these backdoors and some malicious insertions like rootkits. So some well-known rootkit examples like here, first is Land Davis and Steven Deck wrote the earliest known rootkit in the early 1990s. Then second, Anti-Rootkit, one of the first malicious rootkit targeted at Windows OS. Then third, Hacker Defender. This early Trojan altered augmented the OS at a very low level of functions calls. Okay. And fourth, Missy Valley. The first rootkit targeting the Mac OS X appeared in 2009, and this rootkit creates hidden system calls and kernel threads. Then next, Greek wiretapping in 2004-05. Intruders installed a rootkit that targeted Ericsson's AXE PBX. Okay. And then next is GOS. So GOS first identifies in July 2007 is a Trojan horse that steals banking information by man in the browser keystroke logging and from grabbing. And then next is Tuxnet, the first known rootkits for industrial control systems. Okay. And the last here, Flame, a computer malware discovered in 2012 that attacks computers running Windows OS. And it can record audio, screenshots, keyboard activities, and network traffic. Okay, all these resources are from tutorialspoints.com. So you can go and check for the ethical hacking regarding theories from this tutorialspoint.com. Okay, so I will show another book related to this rootkit. Okay, so the book. Book is related to I will show on the net. Okay, so the cover is here, you can see here cover page. Okay, so A Beginner's Guide Malware Rootkit and Botnets. Okay, Christopher E. C. Ellison. Okay, Christopher C. Ellison's author is Christopher C. Ellison. And on the page 32, I think, page number 32. Okay, so I already I have opened okay here I have already opened here the page on the wave. Okay, so chapter 3. Okay, so it covers the details about rootkits, clock of the rootkits, name of the topic. Okay, and here already given the definitions. Okay, environment mechanics like operating system, kernels, user mode and kernel mode, rings. Okay, using rootkits. Okay, to control the system and switching from user mode to kernel mode. Okay, then types of rootkits, user mode rootkits and kernel mode rootkits. So basically there are two types of rootkits. Okay, and then rootkit techniques like here hooking and DLL injections and direct kernel objects manipulation. So you can study all about this details regarding rootkits from this book for ethical hacking only. Okay, so do not follow some you can say hacking paths that are not good for your system or also for others. So always follow the rules related to ethical hacking and safely browse the system or access using rootkit. Okay, so today that's all for rootkit. Okay, thank you.